Hi, good morning. So myself, I'm Dr. Rangarao, working as associate professor in the Department of Biotechnology, Vignan University. So I'm going to deal with biochemistry. So this course actually covers entire chemical process associated with the living cells at molecular level and a clear-cut idea about various molecular and biochemical process governing the production of energy in the cells. The biochemistry actually is having a various applications. The biochemistry using food and nutrition, the biochemistry using molecular biology, and then plant biotechnology, plant biochemistry, and then cell biology. So biochemistry has various applications in industrial. So this is the actually most important topic. So this is actually people are working in cell biology in the pharmaceutical company. Actually, they are going to actually do some of the cells interactions and then some of the titration methods using various chemical, and then they are observing here cell how the actual interaction happened. So this is actually it covers actually under the biochemistry aspects. So there are actually having a various applications this biochemistry. So people are using pharmaceutical industry, and some of the people are using in the food applications. So the biochemistry has a various potential aspects because today we are living in the human body. So there are a lot of pathways. So citric acid cycle, and then lipids, proteins, carbohydrates. So they're all actually bioactive molecules. So next, coming to course outcomes. So students will be able to understand the structures, function, and interaction between biological molecules, and the student able to understand the various mechanisms involved in the enzyme reaction, and acquire knowledge in various pathways in intermediate metabolism and bioenergetics, gain sufficient insights into redox biochemistry, able to articulate the time, apply specialized language and knowledge relevant to biochemistry. This unit actually covers learn about carbohydrates and understand the elucidation of carbohydrates, to learn about different types of the carbohydrates in different materials. So the concepts of biochemistry, carbohydrates. So what are the actually carbohydrates and what are the types of the carbohydrates? So there are different types of the carbohydrates. It depends on the sugar molecules. So this actually covers this concept, monosaccharides, disaccharides, and oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides, and complex carbohydrates, conformation of furanose and pyranose, and then glycosidic bond, glycogen, starch, and dextrose, and cellulose, glycoproteins, and glycoaminoglycans, and lectins. So these are actually carbohydrates. We are going to learn more about this one in this course. So what is actually what is carbohydrate? The carbohydrate is associated with the carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. These are actually made up of this one carbohydrates. And then what are the types of carbohydrate? There are different types of the carbohydrate like monosaccharides and disaccharides and polysaccharides. Well, we have provided here some of the examples here. And then when actually happen the carbohydrate actually react with the water, then it will form the two sugar units. And similarly, when it happen the condensation, then it will form the disaccharide and the water molecule become the product. And then this is the carbohydrate. So monosaccharides. Monosaccharides you can get from the sweet and then fruit. From the fruit we can get the monosaccharides. And then disaccharides we can get the sugarcane, and then polysaccharides. Actually, they are actually tasteless. So this usually we can found in the plant materials. And then functions of carbohydrates, because carbohydrates have a lot of functions. So structurally they are a cellulose and then peptidoglycan and then energy storage. Actually the starch and the glycogen actually stored in the form of the carbohydrates in the plants and then some other materials. And biologically they are very active. They act as a transport and their regulatory aspects and then catalytic and then human response and cell lubrication and support to function. And cell differentiation, cell membrane clotting factors, and protective cellular coat protein. So these are actually some of the biologically active properties they have carbohydrates. And then introduction. What are actually carbohydrates? Carbohydrate is an important source of energy that can be used cells. And these are the carbohydrate is nothing but carbon and then water. It actually made up of this one. And then containing, as I mentioned that previously, carbohydrate is made up of carbon or the nitrogen and then oxygen. How many carbon molecules are there? And then how many hydrogen and then how many oxygen is there? The next is the ratio of hydrogen atoms to oxygen atoms in one molecule of carbohydrates. Usually that is 2:1, and then this is general formula CmH2OM, M is actually number of carbon atoms, and then H2O, N means number of water molecules. And general characteristics, carbohydrates actually we can found in the nature, and then the glucose is synthesized from the carbon dioxide or the water through a photosynthesis process. The stores starch and then converted into cellulose of the plant framework. Carbohydrates perform both structural and then metabolic roles. And carbohydrates are polyhydroxyaldehyde or polyhydroxyketones and other polymers. These are actually carbohydrates. And the carbohydrates are also named saccharides. Then coming to classification. How many classes are there? Monosaccharides. Monosaccharide generally actually it contains one sugar in it. You examples glucose, ribose, galactose, fructose and monose. And similarly disaccharide. Disaccharide with the form of two sugar in it and maltose, sucrose and lactose. And oligosaccharides actually form with 3 to 12 sugar units, and the polysaccharides is nothing but the glycans formed of more than 12 sugar units. Examples, actually polysaccharides actually contain, there are two different polysaccharides like homopolysaccharides and then heteropolysaccharides. Homopolysaccharides are nothing but starch, glycogen and cellulose, and heteropolysaccharides are nothing but heparin. Then what is actually monosaccharides? Monosaccharides, as I mentioned, that it actually contains one sugar molecule. This is a monomer of carbohydrates known as a simple sugar, and they are actually very energy for many cells. Glucose actually converted found in plants and fruits. Fructose can be found in sweet fruit and honey, and galactose can be found in milk. This is examples usually monosaccharides example C6H12O6. And the characteristics of monosaccharides. Now coming to characteristics of monosaccharides, they are actually taste sweet, able to crystallize, water soluble. These are the actual water soluble compounds. And then simplest carbohydrates. There is these actually monosaccharides nothing but reducing sugars. When you heat with benthic solution, monosaccharides reduce the blue copper sulfate solution to brick, red precipitate, and copper oxide. This is example we have given here provided. And then classification of monosaccharides. Coming to classification of monosaccharides, actually depends on the according to the number of carbon atoms they divided. So trioses, tetroses, and pentoses and hexoses. Tetroses contains actually three carbon atoms, glyceraldehyde, dioxy, acetone, and tetrose actually contain four carbon atoms, erythrose, erythrolose, and pentoses actually contain five carbon atoms. They are actually ribose and then ribulose. Hexoses actually contain six carbon atoms, glucose and fructose. And coming to, according to the characteristics of carbonyl group, characteristics of carbonyl group, carbonyl group is nothing but aldehyde and the ketone group. Aldoses, monosaccharides containing aldehyde group, a simple monosaccharide in which carbonyl group comes at the end of the chain. The examples are glucose, galactose, ribose and glyceraldehyde. These are some of the examples. Coming to ketoses, monosaccharides containing ketone group, a simple monosaccharide in which carbonyl group occurs within the chain. Fructose examples, ribulose and dihydroxyacetone. These are some of the examples for the ketoses. Classification based on the characteristics of carbonyl group, as I mentioned that this carbonyl group actually contain either at the end of the chain or in the middle of the chain. So these are actually sometimes combination, maybe carbon 1 and carbon 2, the position it will change. Glucose is aldohexose, a 6 carbon monosaccharides containing an aldehyde group that is actually called aldose, whereas fructose is a ketohexose, a 6 carbon monosaccharide containing a ketone group that is actually ketose. And simplest aldose is glyceraldehyde. The simplest ketose is dihydroxyacetone. They are constitutional isomers of each other, sharing the formula C3H6O3. Here actually I provided some of the examples. Glyceraldehyde, you can see here at the end of the chain aldehyde group, and whereas you can see dihydroxyacetone, and we have provided here the structure. You can see the ketone group actually in the middle of the chain. So these are the examples of aldoses of D-glyceraldehyde, D-erythrose, and D-ribose, and D-glucose. These are some of the examples for aldoses. And coming to ketoses, these are some of the examples we provided for our understanding ketoses, erythrolose, regulose, and xylose, and then fructose. These are some of the examples. The summary of this one, the carbohydrates are complex biochemical structures that serve vital functions in the human body, composed of building block of sugar. They are the main source of energy for the body. One or more sugars linked together to form carbohydrate. Complex carbohydrates consist of thousands of repeating sugar units and are the major constituents of starch. Nucleotides are also composed of carbohydrates. Thank you all.